promising young man, bright future ahead. In case you don't stay for the Q&A, I want to give thank you to John Cameron, who is playing the role of Antoine, the waiter in Eiffel Trifle. And he's very talented, multi-dimensional professor, runs writing workshops, teaches university, and wonderful actor. Second of my shows he's been in. I'm fortunate to have a kind of a troupe that actually will perform in my plays when I ask them, which is a blessing for me, and I just appreciate them. Vinny Ali, a very hardworking young man, and gives of himself with untiringly. Cyndie Romer, extremely versatile actress. So I think I've said enough, and let the show begin. Thank you.
Mademoiselle, I'm very sorry to see you so distressed. Perhaps you would go down to the observation platform just down the stairs for some fresh air. Would you like that?
No.
Would you like a bit more time to order?
Yes.
Mademoiselle, the gentleman who was seated here, he will be returning.
What do you think?
Monsieur, you have decided?
Yeah, I'll have the trois fromage platter, the beef tournedot, and the escargot. And do I have to choose a dessert now, or can I tell you later?
Unfortunately, the complete order must come in at once. Else, the chef, he will be very cross with me.
Well, in that case, I'll have the Fombois glass explosion.
How can you be so damn blasé?
Très bon, monsieur. You will not be disappointed, hein? Monsieur, may I speak with you about something unusual? To do so, I will need to seat myself next to you very briefly.
I was actually hoping to enjoy some solitude and the wonderful view.
Please, please, monsieur.
All right.
You have no doubt to notice this very sad young lady nearby. This may be completely out of line, but I cannot bear to see her so unhappy. I cannot bear it. Do you understand? Don't you? Thank you. She reminds me so much of my mother. God rest her soul. In her younger days, of course. My mother died 1 year ago today. Those sweeping eyebrows, that exquisite nose, Perhaps I said too much. Maybe you would simply prefer to sit alone.
No, it's all right. Please.
Thank you. So you see, I cannot bear to see anyone who so resembles my mother to be so miserable. I was hoping that perhaps you, a nice young man, maybe of a similar age, that you might, politely of course, ask if you could sit with her, and then somehow improve her mood. It would be totally inappropriate for me, as a waiter or an older man, to do so.
I think I tried to pick her up.
Even so, such is no crime, eh? Chercher la femme. Tis universally understood, you see, here, that the woman, she must be pursued. And should she shoo you away, you simply retreat, n'est-ce pas?
Excusez-moi, madame. I was wondering if you would mind terribly if I joined you.
I don't know. Who are you? Mr. Glace Explosion?
I'm just a guy that was sitting over there. Thought we might have a little chat.
Are you feeling sorry for me? Because I can't stand people feeling sorry for me.
No, of course not. It just seemed like you needed some company. You must know I don't do this, ever.
Sure.
I don't even know how to begin. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Ronaldo. And you see, I study birds for a living.
Birds?
Yeah. In French, well, so. I study them constantly. You might say I'm oiseau at the wazoo, as it were.
Which type of birds do you study?
Only the nightingale, the most romantic bird of romance and poetry. I'm sure you've heard of Ode to a Nightingale. Though there's...
It's part of my PhD thesis at European literature, so quite obviously.
And pray tell, what is your name?
Bird studies sound lovely to you, but honestly, I cannot imagine a more boring subject, unless armadillos or snails or slugs.
Oh, won't you never insult a snail in this country?
It's for the advice. So are you here by yourself?
Oui. I live in an apartment in Marais. As for our other companions, if you are interested.
They never cross one.
Perhaps it's a similar situation to your own.
You don't know me. But go on, maybe I'll tell you.
Well, my girlfriend, Claudia, of 6 months, recently left me 2 days ago. As you can tell, I'm quite lonely and a little heartbroken. Maybe like yourself.
So tell me, why did you come over here and talk to me? And I want complete honesty.
Complete, eh? You won't accept 90%? In truth, you seem sad. And in all of us, we try to seek out those who are sad and try to help them. Second, you are very lovely. And I defy my own natural shyness to come over here and sit next to you.
Something like that? Often.
I've never seen a woman half as ravishing as you.
You sound like 15 other Romeos. Please, why don't you just go back to your table?
But you asked for complete honesty, and now you must suffer through some high compliments. It's part of the package.
So about a package when you said you could sit here?
And there's more.
There's more. Would you like to order something before you go on?
Of course. Monsieur! Monsieur! I'll have the escargot and a platter of frog's legs.
Très bon.
Merci.
Why would you order something so disgusting?
I like to eat what my birds eat.
Well, I may have to leave when your order arrives.
No.
You'll have to pay my tab.
Oh, please. Don't leave. Never.
Excuse me? Ever? You're sounding very creepy all of a sudden, Mr. Ronaldo.
My apologies. I am too intense for my own good sometimes.
And that's it? No more reasons?
There's a couple of them. For one, I'd like to know more about you.
First, tell me why Claudia left you.
Must I? Truth is too painful to speak in truth in full. So I'll leave it at this. I was too possessive. What about you and your,
my Carlos. The one who just left. He said he had to return to Buenos Aires for an engineering position he just couldn't pass up. And I refused to leave Paris. I love it here. So we both knew that was it. Long distance romance is simply too.
His loss is
how
great
did
loss.
You know? You still don't know me. I could be an axe murderer. But go on. Tell me your third charm or your sixth reason. Your math is overwhelming.
I wish to charm you.
Well, now you have me laughing. I never thought crying in a public restaurant could be so. So go ahead. Charm the pants off me. No. That doesn't sound right. Just charm me.
I have some pictures here that I'd like to share with you. Tell me, have you ever been to Ginevra?
Of course.
But I bet you've never been to Ginevra when there are no visitors.
Well, no.
I've been there early in the morning, and there's no one there except me and my birds. Beautiful flycatchers, you see them. Tufted titmice, and of course, yellow finches. But not only that, I'm also an amateur pastry chef. Not a pro by any sense, but I do all right by myself and my friends. Here we have my apricot tranche cake with almonds. My choco orange cake. Yes. And a tiramisu. I like to branch off a little bit.
This does sound intriguing, I must admit. I think I would like that very much. Do you know someone at the Porte de Verne?
Of course. The membership director. He would do me this favor in a thrice. He too shares my passion for birds.
And the pastries do look delicious. Do you think that the way to a woman's heart is through her stomach?
One can only hope.
Go ahead, tell me the more charms.
The more charming I get, the more I look. I wonder where our waiter is.
Tell me about the waiter.
Oh, Antoine.
I somehow have a feeling he is somehow involved in you being here. Tell me the truth.
Yes. It's because of him that I am here. He implicitly said that I should speak with you to try to raise you.
Monsieur.
Oh.
Ah.
Your escargot and the frog legs.
I don't know which is more gross.
You must try this. You've been in Paris how long and you've never tried?
Are you purposely trying to gross me out?
Not at all. Merely trying to introduce you to new, exotic foods.
So back to the waiter. How is he involved in you being here?
My dear Antoine, he So that you were very upset, and he asked me explicitly to talk to you. Try to raise your spirits.
Well, the waiters shouldn't be so intrusive. Perhaps the management here needs to know about Antoine's behavior.
No, please, don't. He's more than just a waiter. He's a person. He's not born romantic. Cares about us.
Us? How did he know there would be an us to care about?
You can see it in your eyes that you were right for me.
What, does he run the Eiffel Tower dating service?
And if he does, we should invest in him. Darling.
Darling? Are we really at the darling stage already?
Why not? We'll just depart to the Champs Elysees.
We shall go for a while. I love this music. Do you compose things? Do you think of songs in your head?
As much as you do, my love. I have one song that I've been working on since I laid eyes upon you.
Amuse me.
You must dance with me. It's the only way that I will share with you.
Only one Marguerite, no one as sweet as you. I dream of life with you, never leave my side. I love you, Marguerite, with every ounce of my being. Marguerite.
Why I hugged you. Why I seemed to trust you. Am I a fool again?
Of course you are. We both are. But what do your instincts tell you?
To be careful. So tell me again. That man told you to approach me.
Yes. I met him for 3 seconds by an implicit trust in him.
I don't understand. Why would he jeopardize his job? Why would he endanger his position here?
Why do people do crazy things in life?
But I just...
There's no buts in romance, my love.
Is that what we have here?
I say yes.
Shall we take that moment?
Monsieur et dame, the meal that you have enjoyed so far, it is my treat. I have paid your tab. Please forgive me. I know I am out of line, but I also overheard that you are going to walk in Paris. Would you please accept this basket of food and bottle of champagne?
Why did you do this?
You reminded me so much of my mother in her younger days. Perhaps you can see the resemblance.
I do see there's a similarity.
Oh yes, so very much, and I could not bear to see you unhappy. My father, he abandoned her. She never quite got over it.
You didn't want history to repeat itself.
No, never. Never again. Forgive me for being such an old fool.
You are more than forgiven.
Now, enjoy Barry. My mother, she will sleep well tonight. Bonne nuit.
Minutes for the next part of the show.
My plays, and they're short, so don't blink, but I hope they're good. A couple of things. We are going to have a 5-minute intermission, and the evening is my brief remarks, followed by Eiffel Trifle, followed by a break, followed by appreciation, and then we will have snacks and beverages, if you can be patient till then, hiding under that yellow blanket, don't go there too soon. Then we'll have a Q&A with the cast and myself, if you're interested. And that shall be the evening. So also, if you'd like to be on my personal email list and you're not already getting any from me, please see my wife Martha over there, with curly hair. And a few thank yous. First to GilbertoVega in the back there. Gil, waving your hand. Great director. 22-year-old wunderkind. Did I say any German experts who can tell me if I pronounced that correctly? He's going to be working at the Arden Theater in a great apprenticeship program. And he came in here and is just doing everything from building bicycle support units with carpenter